then everything reverts in something like 30 years. If you want to, you could also add a reference slide here, I think it's approximately 33, and say, just to point out that you might have, I think, I'm not looking at color scheme here or whatever. So, you know, you can kind of see that, well, you know, if you look here, then everything will go back here. So, that's my next one. So now, you know, you start talking to, this is pretty, I mean, it's a pretty powerful chart, but if I show this to my marketing team, most likely they would be like, well, you know, I want to make it, you know, this thing is static, and I'm like, okay, so if I need to talk to my marketing people, I need to do something more. So if you recall, I talked about Hans Rosling. So Hans Rosling sort of claimed to fame is that he has all these moving bubble plots and this and that. So the videos are all about that. So because of that, every software vendor basically had decided to create a moving bubble plot model. So and then all these marketing people wanted a moving bubble plot. So I'm like, okay, fine. I'll give you a moving bubble plot. So, where's the bubble plot? I think it is this bubble plot thing. Okay. Yeah. So, well, we want that to move. Oh, but notice that this last one's not here because I did it on the fly platform. So, I need to first go back here and say, add this to my data table. So, now it appears as an additional column. So, you don't have to do it this way. You could basically create your income gap ratio. But this on the fly thing is in case you experiment with it, you don't like it, you can get rid of it without connecting the data set. So over here, I have my income gap ratio now. So I am, that's my Y. My X is going to be the time of the year. It's going to be year two. And then I'm going to make the size of the bubbles corresponding to the top 1% income. And that's the first version I will show. So then here you can change all kinds of things like speed, bubble size, just my personal preference. I actually prefer my bubbles to be like squares, but you don't have to. And so, you know, first thing I do is like, let's sort of play it. And, you know, apparently this makes people happier. And maybe I want it faster or something. Well, okay, so that's basically the same type of chart as before. It just starts moving around. Now, okay, so the bubble plot has multiple dimensions. So one last thing that I would try is to say, well, can I bring in some data to help me interpret this data set? So one of the things I was wondering about is, does inequality correlate with the economic prosperity? So would it be that in recession periods, things start to grow differently than when we have a boom period? So what I need to do there is to merge in some economic data, which I have found, which is completely defined by GDP growth. So that's my GDP growth data. And so what I want to do here is to merge this to my data set here based on the year. So I need to do that. Basically the same kind of version from before. So this is a new data set. The only difference is so we can see some merging issues, right? There are no growth data for the first number of years, so I can't exclude it. So that will be the job. So next thing is I want to have more discrete colors so I can see these are recessionary periods and these are not. So I'm going to need to define my here is another one of these assumptions that you're making as an analyst. So I'm not claiming any rigor up here. I'm just going to illustrate. So don't shoot me. I'm going to if GDP growth is greater than 2%, I will call this a boom. And I'm going to basically say if GDP growth is let's say less than 0, this is going to be a bust. And then this will be stable. It's called stable. Of course, in reality, you need multiple quarters and tables to bust. But that's the fact that I need colors of character. So now I want to assign colors to these. So blue is red, green, bus is black, let's say, and stable is some kind of like gray. Okay, so now I want to go to global plot, but we know this is a new data set, so nothing is more than I can recall. Oh, that's good. That was one of the best of whoever it is. Thank God. GDP growth, I want this to be my color, so now I'm doing it today. So what they didn't do though is to retain my thing. So I could have saved my script, but I didn't, so I have to do all these things again. Because I'm so particular about my squares and we don't have the colors. So start playing in and you can kind of see. So this is one of the problems with the, wait, did I do this the wrong way? Boom is red, no. nobody challenged me on that. boom should be black ink and boss should be red. Okay, that makes sense. Let's see. Another chain, okay. Apparently it doesn't know how to change, so it doesn't matter. We can go back to the launch analysis and oh my god, it doesn't like me in squares. Okay, it doesn't matter. There you go. That looks more like it. So we have these sort of boom times and bust times. And let's say I'm going to have to start again. So basically, then you use this to explore your theory. So it turns out that, I mean, as far as I can tell, whenever there's like a bust or a red stuff, things are usually pretty stable. And it seems like it's, when the economy is booming, that the equality or the changes in equality. Oh, this is like literally just a visual thing, so we can't really put too much credit on it. But in any case, that's the type of sketching that I do a lot here, and I'm going to just summarize for you. So we move to this version. The whole point of this is that even when you have a nice sort of plot, it turns out that the key to the original plot is you pick the right two metrics. But then even within these two metrics, you can still do a lot of work in terms of sometimes you're changing the chart form, say from scale plot to line plot. Sometimes you're changing the metric or doing the analysis of changing from the gap to a ratio to really help you kind of get to a chart that you really like in terms of delivering that message in the most easy to recognize way. You can also go overboard, but you know, if you work with marketing, I think Chuck here has said he likes the last one. Things that move around and kind of generate attention apparently is a good thing. So In this whole process, what are some of the tools that I have brought to bear here? Things like associating colors and orders with column data, using the formula to create various new variables. I've also shown you that you can actually do a formula that is more for temporary experimentation that you don't necessarily have to save to your data set. Also, categorizing data using the merging of data, other types of data to explore the why, not just the how. And all of this is kind of moving your chart to that next level that hopefully will have an impact on decision makers. So, just a conclusion for this section. The raw data I found really make good charts. So if you just dump your raw data into a tool, it's very unlikely to give you some input. Upfront analysis and thinking about the data is really important. You know, what is your question that you're trying to answer?